Thank you, Patty. Yes, because he lives. We do get to endure, not endure, but we're blessed with all the good things that we have every day. Welcome to worship this morning, especially those of you here in person and those that are worshiping with us online today. Outdoor Holy Communion will be celebrated Wednesday, June the 1st at noon. Please contact the church office if you would like to participate. Next Sunday is a celebration of Pentecost. The tradition is to wear red. You're encouraged to do so if you would like. That's next Sunday. On Wednesday, June the 8th, Good Hope is hosting a healthy congregation workshop. That's at 6:30 in the evening. At 5:30, there'll be a boxed lunch dinner provided by the congregation. The workshop session itself, though, will begin at 6:30. Those of you that have participated in the previous healthy congregation workshops are encouraged to come back. And those of you who have not, please participate. You're encouraged to contact the church office so we know how many box lunches to plan for. You've been very generous in bringing in grocery supplies that go to the Salvation Army. A few people are going to be needed to unload that food Thursday, June the 2nd, 11 o'clock in the morning at the Salvation Army. Please get in touch with Lori Burkhardt if you can help. That's this coming Thursday. Okay? We have an individual who celebrated a birthday yesterday. I asked him if he was 39, and he said yes. Jerry Town, happy birthday, Patty. As we have been doing the last several weeks, we'd like to take a few moments for some silent prayer for around the world, but I think this past week we found that we especially need peace in the United States also. So if you would, please. Amen. Thank you. If you'd stand as you're able, please. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us sing our opening song, Let There Be Praise. Let there be praise, let there be joy in our hearts, for grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Back to the water, wash away our sin. Welcome us, O Father, back to your home again. Bless your sons and your daughters, and let the feast begin. Let it begin.
God, who's rich in mercy, loved us even when we are dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen.
You take us back to the water. You wash away our sin. You welcome us, O Father, back to your home again. You bless your sons and your daughters. Now let the feast begin. Let it begin. Lord, your mercy.
Washed away by the cross.
Let us pray together the prayer of the day. O God, form the minds of your faithful people into your one will. Make us love what you command and desire what you promise, that amid all the changes of this world, our hearts may be fixed where true joy is found. Your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. The first reading comes from the book of Acts, chapter 16. One day, as we were going to the place of prayer, we met a slave girl who had a spirit of divination and brought her owners a great deal of money by fortune telling. While she followed Paul and us, she would cry out, "These men are the slaves of the Most High God who proclaim to you a way of salvation." She kept doing this for many days, but Paul, very much annoyed, turned and said to the spirit, "I order you now in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her." And it came out that very hour. But when her owners saw that their hope of making money was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace before the authorities. When they brought them before the magistrates, they said, "These men are disturbing our city. They're Jews and are advocating customs that are not lawful for us as Romans to adopt or observe." The crowd joined in attacking them, and the magistrates had stripped them of their clothing and ordered them to be beaten with rods. After they had been given a severe flogging, they threw them into prison and ordered the jailer to keep them securely. Following these instructions, he put them in the innermost cell and fastened their feet in the stocks. Now about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly there was an earthquake, so violent that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's chains were unfastened. When the jailer woke up and saw the prison doors wide open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself, since he was supposed to wake up when the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted in a loud voice, "Do not harm yourself, for we are all here." The jailer called for lights, and rushing in, he fell down trembling before Paul and Silas. Then he brought them outside and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" They answered, "Believe on the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved, you and your household." They spoke the word of the Lord to him and all who were in his house. At the same hour of the night, he took them and washed their wounds. Then he and his entire family were baptized without delay. He brought them up into the house and set food before them, and he and his entire household rejoiced that he had become a believer in God. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We read Psalm 97 responsively. The Lord reigns, let the earth rejoice, let the multitude of the isles be glad. Clouds and darkness surround the Lord. Righteousness and justice are the foundations of God's throne. Fire goes before the Lord, burning up enemies on every side. Lightnings light up the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens declare your righteousness, O Lord, and all the people see your glory. Confounded be all who worship carved images and delight in false gods. Bow down before the Lord, all you gods. Zion hears and is glad, and the cities of Judah rejoice because of your judgments, O Lord. For you are the Lord most high over all the earth. You are exalted far above all gods. You who hate the Lord, hate evil. God guards the lives of the saints and rescues them from the hand of the wicked. Light dawns for the righteous and joy for the honest of heart. Rejoice in the Lord, you righteous, and give thanks to God's holy name. The second reading comes from the book of Revelation, chapter 22. See, I am coming soon. My reward is with me to repay according to everyone's work. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who wash their robes so that they will have the right to the tree of life and may enter the city by the gates. It is I, Jesus, who sent my angel to you with his testimony for the churches. I am the root and the descendant of David, the bright morning star. The Spirit and the bride say, come. And let everyone who hears say, come. And let everyone who is thirsty come. Let anyone who wishes take the water of life as a gift. The one who testifies to these things says, surely I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with all the saints. Amen. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
And the children can come down for children's message. You're going to have to gather around right here. Come down in the front. All right. Well, how are you all today? Oh, it's just like last Sunday. Good. Let's try that again. How are you this morning? Good. All right. Well, I brought my special lovely thing. Anybody remember what this is? Or what it does? Oh, good. We'll do it again. Well, in the reading that I just did, I used some big words from Revelation. It said, Jesus is the Alpha and Omega. So if you had to learn the Greek alphabet, the first letter you would say would be A, Alpha. The last one we say Z, but in the Greek alphabet, it is Omega. So Jesus is the beginning and the end. He is the Alpha and the Omega. So what I thought we'd try to do today is we would try to see if we can prove that if we keep Jesus in our life and do all the things that he tells us to do, we should be able to love and to light up and make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Oh, if you could see their faces, they're looking at me like, what? Well, I'm going to be the beginning. You're going to be the end, Carter, okay? Oh, let's see if I can do this. All right, give me your hand. Okay, hook up with Tegan. Okay, Aubrey, Lane, Carter, and you got to do it. Oh. Break your hand, Lane. Okay, try it again. Hook it up. All right. Okay, I'm going to unhook. So that shows us that if we allow the electricity of the Lord flow through us, hopefully someday you'll be able to show light and you'll be able to show love to everybody. So how do we do that? Besides holding our hands and joining together. Can you think of anything we do? Whoa, you guys are so talkative today. Anything at all? Well, let's see, Carter, what did you do today with Dad? Yeah, you lit the candles, that's right. Did any of you come to church today? Quick, they're nodding their heads. Let's okay. And we go to Sunday school, and pretty soon you're going to be shaking the tambourine, doing the holly, holly, hallelujah, right? Do you love your parents? Do you ever clean your room or do something they say? Yes. Oh, good. Those are all things that we can do. So let's join up. All right, let's see if it's still, oh, it still works. We're doing good. And if we break it, so if we've done something wrong or something bad, all we have to do is say, gee, dear Lord, I've goofed it up again. Will you forgive me? And he says, yes, and we're ready to go, right? All right, good. So this week, try to join together and do something that shows love so that you can light up for God too. All right, let's bow our head and fold our hands and repeat after me. Dear Lord, thank you for your love and help me to love others. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Good. Please stand for the gospel acclamation and get your tambourines.
Gospel according to St. John, the 17th chapter, verses 20 to 26. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus prayed, I not only ask on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one. As you, Father, are in me and I am you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one as we are one, I and them, and you and me, that we may become completely one, so that the world may know that you have sent me and have loved me even as you have loved me. Father, I desire that those also whom you have given me may be with me where I am to see my glory, which you have given me because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you, and these know that you have sent me. I made your name known to them, and I will make it known so that the love with which you have loved me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. My prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message, that all may be one, Father, just as you are in me and I am in you. In March 1935, Charles de Gaulle and Gaston Paluski realized that the Nazi movement in Germany is going to become a real threat to the people of France. And so they proposed a bill to the Assemblée Nationale to create a specialized corps of an armored division as soon as possible to prepare for an eventual confrontation with Germany. However, the president of that council turned it down. On May 10, 1940, France was officially attacked by the Nazis, and 46 days later, France was forced to surrender. The enemy had won. But Charles de Gaulle was far from defeated. From the BBC radio station in London, de Gaulle encouraged the French people to resist the Nazis and to never give up. The government of Vichy in France ordered de Gaulle to return to France. De Gaulle continued to call the French people to arms. The government of Vichy revoked his promotion to rank of general. And on July 4, 1940, de Gaulle was sentenced to 4 years in prison, fined for disobeying an order. And then in August of the same year, he was sentenced to death, dishonorably discharged from the army, and had all of his property confiscated. Well, from all that, it's reasonably clear that the French were far from united. In fact, the division within the government and within the ranks was one of the major reasons they were so easily invaded by the Nazis on June 25th, 1940. The French were far from being united. We return again this week to that Passover meal on Monday, Thursday, the night before Christ was arrested and crucified. The disciples have gathered with Jesus to celebrate the Passover meal. And I'm sure that the disciples gathered for their final meal, what they thought would be their final meal with Jesus, did not feel united. I'm sure they were frightened, uncertain of what really was happening, insecure, perhaps scrappy. I'm sure they might have been squabbling among themselves. I suspect they were very surprised to hear Jesus pray for them before he was to send them out on each of their individual missions. How do you feel when someone prays out loud for you? Do you feel comforted, vulnerable, grateful, honored that someone would pray for you? Do you feel humbled, appreciative but somewhat awkward, appreciative that somebody really cares about you? Perhaps what is most important to us is that someone else is making the request to God. As it was for the disciples, so it is crucial for us to return to the prayer that Jesus lifts up to his Father. This prayer describes the hope of Jesus as well as the vision of what we as followers are to look like, and more importantly, how we are to live our daily lives together. We will be one with Jesus and the Father. And it's clear that the words spoken by Jesus are for everyone, then and now, and especially for those who believe in Jesus. And the prayer is lifted up because Jesus knows well before the disciples do and well before we do that there's going to be bickering and rage and unrest, and most definitely division. This is the reason for asking of his Father that all be one as the Father and Son are one. That we be united together against the forces attempting each day to create division and distancing and disagreement and unrest. The world is often used as a means of describing those who oppose Jesus. However, it's for the love of the world that God sent his only Son into this world. And note in the prayer that Jesus prays not only for his own or for those who believe and trust in him, but also for the world that Jesus was sent to live among us in human form. Jesus is requesting unity and love between those who have been given to him and the Father, so that as Jesus shares, the world may believe that you have sent me. And the goal of this prayer of Jesus is that even those who have been hostile to his coming into this world may believe that the Father truly sent him to save this world. As we return to the text, John reminds us that Jesus came to make the love of God known to us, even though we do not deserve this greatest gift that we could receive. And as indicated, Jesus prays that the oneness requested can be real and active. And of course, Jesus is at the core of this requested oneness, so that everybody may be reunited in and through him. If we were to talk to Apostle John, I suspect he would ask us to examine ourselves, our lives, our hearts. Are we truly united with Christ and the Father? And we can offer thanks and praise to God that our unity may be received as a gift through Jesus Christ. And we can share this story of Jesus with those that we see struggling with division and discord, how they might become united with Christ as they receive him as their Savior and Son of God. With the division and unrest today throughout our communities, the nation, and the world, this prayer reminds us that our unity, our oneness, is to be a sign to the rest of the world of the love of God for us in Jesus Christ. And love for each other is needed in order to achieve this oneness and unity. As part of a family, as a member of a congregation, you realize that within that love there's going to be disagreements and squabbles. We're only human. The mystery of the embodiment of God in human form or incarnation is that God desired unity with us so much that he became one of us. And it's in that moment that we're drawn into the oneness of God the Creator, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And it's with the help of the Holy Spirit that we live in the oneness that Jesus is requesting. Yesterday, Men of Hope Bible study, our study was on the first few verses, chapter 1 of James. And James was talking about you should not be double-minded. Because if you're double-minded, then you're split. You're going many directions. You have to have a single mind, and that needs to be directed and focused on Jesus Christ. You've heard it many times in the past, in the New Testament. You cannot serve two masters. Because then your attention, your efforts are divided. We need to be singly focused on Jesus Christ, our Savior. Last week, we received the message again that only Christ can provide that ultimate peace that we desperately seek. Today, the Apostle John shares with us that Jesus prays for us. He prays for us. He lifts us up to the Father that we might receive the gift of unity and oneness through him. And his wish is for the world to receive the same gift, that all may be one with the Father, all may be one with the Father and the Son. And in light of what happened this week in Texas, I pray it may be so. Amen.
Confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Dear Lord, you've set us free from captivity to sin and death. So we pray today for the church, for people in need, and all of your creation. Holy God, make your people one as you and your Son are one. Extend the gifts we have been given by your Spirit to all people, especially those experiencing division or questioning your love. And make worthy the work of scientists bring innovation and well-being to humanity through their discoveries. And we remember, Lord, those who have died in war, both military and civilians. May we honor them by seeking peaceful solutions to the conflicts that arise among nations and people. We pray for peace in the Ukraine and other places in the world experiencing strife of any kind. Bring safety and hope to all living there. And we ask especially to grant healing to all who are overwhelmed by illness, depression, or worry. And today we remember especially in our congregation, Reggie Berg, Connie Smith, Amy Eastman, John Amon, Marge Bodnot, Mike Cawley, Miriam Everetts, Ruth Lady Pollock, Carol May, Bob Norris, Christina Oakes, Riley, Rick Schnabel, Heidi Walton, Marion Smith, and all who we name now in our hearts. Open each of these to receive your health and salvation in Christ Jesus through the Spirit's gift of faith. And now stir into imagination and understanding throughout the church in the world of poets, theologians, and hymn writers. Lead us into new visions and new expressions of your presence. We give thanks especially for Vicar Tansy's ministry here at Good Hope. Guide and direct each of us as we move toward her ordination. And now we come to you with really heavy hearts, dear Lord, for 21 lives were lost in a school shooting in Texas. We pray for strength, for peace of heart, for those families who lost their loved ones. Bring healing to those wounded in the attack, and most of all, bring peace to this hurting world. And now we ask that you unite us with the saints who have died and been raised in Jesus. Train us to wait with eager longing for Christ to come again, even as we sense his presence with us now.
In your mercy, O God, respond to these prayers and renew us by your life-giving Spirit, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. We receive the offering. Please stand as you're able. Pray with me, for I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Amen. Amen. People of good hope, we're grounded in faith, gathered in love, and sent with a purpose so others may gain the kingdom. We sing, Crown Him with Many Crowns.
Thank you.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Go in peace, tell what God has done.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.